Welcome back, everyone. I'm Jordan Giesecke, and this is The Limiting Factor. The day that I released the Shirley Meng video, I managed to find her email address, and I sent her a copy. She responded, and that's what we'll be discussing today. In my email, I asked two questions. Could she provide any feedback on the video, and would she be willing to do an interview? She responded by thanking me for checking with her and providing feedback on two points in the video. First, I wasn't aware that this was called a Ragone plot. A Ragone plot is a graph that compares energy storage devices. The Ragone plot I used was just for cathode rather than the entire cell. I had several intents with that graph. The first was to show energy density at the cell level and to show that we are currently at 250 watt-hours a kg. The second was that the Battery 500 consortium, which includes Shirley Meng, is targeting 500 watt-hours a kg in the next few years at the cell level. And third, after that, we still have decades of advancements to look forward to. For those purposes, this plot would have been more accurate because it is at the cell level. The plot is exponential, so 10 to the second is 100 watt-hours a kg, and 10 to the third is 1,000 watt-hours a kg. In the X-ray diffraction video, I stated that what we were seeing was particles moving back and forth. This was incorrect given the context. These were lithium ions moving back and forth. An ion is a particle, but in the next slide, I showed an image of an actual metallic particle, and this would have led you to believe they were one and the same. The two are closely related, but separate and distinct. What's actually happening here is that the lithium ions exit and enter metallic particles, which is what causes them to expand, contract, and degrade. I was really excited to get this feedback, because it means everything else in the video passed the scrutiny of one of the world's leading battery experts. If you watched that video, you know that I highlighted that Shirley implied in 2017 that we should be on track for a 500 watt-hour a kg battery chemistry reveal by 2022. Then, a few weeks ago, she advised that 2020 will be a big year. I advised that she was likely referring to Battery Investor Day, because her lab has links to Maxwell Technology, a Tesla acquisition. Shirley didn't make any comment on this. You can read into that what you like, but for me, it's a sign that I'm on a good track with my research. If some of Shirley's thinking has gone into the Tesla Maxwell battery, I have a very good idea of what it's going to look like, and I'll be sharing that information in my next video within the next week. The second question I asked is if she would be willing to do an interview. She didn't comment on this, and I didn't take that as a yes or no. When I get the subscriber count up on this channel, I'll follow up with her again with your support. And with that in mind, be sure to like and subscribe below. In order to interview people like Shirley Meng and go to events like Battery Investor Day, I need to get my subscriber count up to at least 1,000. I've also started a Patreon. You'll find the details of that in the description. I appreciate all of your support, and thanks for tuning in.